Good afternoon. Welcome to the Envoy presentation. I'm from the Lizan. I'm from Envoy. I'm based in the US. So today I'm going to do a presentation about Envoy. So before I introduce Envoy, would you like to first talk about Envoy history? In the first half of 2015, it was the beginning of development. The founder of Envoy is Mike Fire. So Envoy project was open sourced in 2016. And attracted a lot of attention from the community, Google and IBM. And other large companies all paid attention to this project. When I was in Google at that time, I also joined the development of Envoy. CNCF. Since then, Envoy has made a lot of contributions to their community. And last year, Envoy became the third graduation project at CNCF. So that's the history. So I would like to now address why Envoy was developed. In the industry, in the microservice networking, in many cases, multiple languages or infrastructures and protocols are used, and also there are different levels of load balance and the different levels of observability. But it's very difficult to get unified observability. For example, retry, circuit breaking, rate limiting, and other distributed systems. Meanwhile, we also need to implement authentication and authorization. That means we need a per language library for service call, but it's not very practical unless this is multinational companies and you only use two or three languages. And also we need a designated team to manage the libraries and language framework. Otherwise, this is extremely difficult. And also debugging in microservice is very difficult. It's highly probable that you are going to fail. And also there's limited visibility into the components such as hosted load balances, databases, cache, etc. And of course, the features such as circuit breaking and retry, these are multiple and partial implementations. It's very difficult to achieve. Also, libraries are incredibly painful to upgrade. For example, if you have CVE, you need to upgrade all the applications. You need to build them before upgrading this whole service. So Envoy is developed to address these issues. The main objective of Envoy is to make the network transparent to applications. And when network and application problems do occur, it should be easy to determine the source of the problem. And you can do this via Envoy. So applications don't have to pay attention to these features. And Envoy can help you to achieve all these functions, such as authorization and retry, etc. Envoy use sidecar. Here, each rectangle is a Kubernetes pod. On each pod, we will have a sidecar proxy. And each application can connect to the network and communicate through sidecar proxy. And so Envoy. Can deal with all the traffic of the application, and then it can offer all those functions I just mentioned. These are the considerations when Envoy was designed. So we can see in the diagram, Envoy is an out-of-process architecture. Has an excellent TCP filter, and also has HTTP/L7 filter architecture, and it's also designed with HTTP/2 first. It has its own service discovery and routine management, including health checking and other load balancing function that other proxies don't support. It has best-in-class observability. All the stacks are sent from Envoy, which means the format of the stacks is unified. In another presentation at 3 o'clock, I will talk about more about observability in service mesh. This is another advantage of Envoy. Envoy is a universal data plane. We call this a XDS API, which means Discovery Service API. Discovery service includes LDS, listener discovery service, CDS, cluster discovery service, and also secret discovery. There are altogether 7 or 8. And the latest one is the TDS and the health checking LTDS. These APIs are based on GIPC streaming. We use portals so to define these APIs and send them to Envoy through gRPC. The advantage of this is when you extend your Envoy, you can avoid a pre-proxy config. And you can control the rest with your control plane. So in the dynamic environment of cloud native, you don't need to manually restart different envoys so as to read the different configurations. So this is the basic architecture of Envoy. In every Envoy, there are low-level workers. Each worker represents a process, and each worker is there are filters. And the traffic is here. A connection is generated, and then they go through the filters. For example, alpha read the filters, and then it's connected with HTTP, LC, and then it will go through the service router and connect with the upstream connection pool. And we'll support a lot of extension, extension as
mentioned before, that is L4, L7 filter. Actually, Envoy itself only account for a small portion of Envoy code. Most of them is for L4 or F7 filter. For example, it can be complete TCP L4 level filter, and the service router is also is another kind of filter at HTTP level. So they are serving as filters. And we also have logons and tracing and house tracker. All these is extendable. As we all know, for example, instead of a message, they are not in Envoy. They are using filters and loggers to extend the functions of Envoy. And also transport sockets, retry policies can also be used by extension as well. Actually, since we open source in 2016, we got a lot of participation. A lot of company adopt Envoy. Here is just a small amount of adopters. Actually, in China, a lot of companies, including Arm, NetEase, also adopt Envoy. Now I would like to invite Mr. Jing Yuxin from NetEase about your use of Envoy in NetEase. First of all, I want to thank you for the introduction of Envoy. Liu Zhang was abroad in his early stage, so his Chinese actually is not the same as what we used to speak. So I would like to talk about how we use Envoy in NetEase. Because time is limited, I will just talk about our use case first. Internally, we have a service mesh, a macro service framework, and when we use Envoy, what kind of work we have done. And second, internally, we have some demands and we want to achieve through Envoy, and how can we extend and have the extension of Envoy to meet our purpose. Internally, we have a department responsible for e-commerce, and they have the service mesh structure, but it's different from the existing service mesh, and they are using the Nginx, and they use console for service discovery. Nginx, as you know, is support plugin to extend. But to connect console, they have a console plug to achieve service discovery. So service discovery cannot be fulfilled by the business. But for their part, at that time, they do not have the service mesh concept, and they are more practical, and they do not have clear demands. For example, for control board, and they do not have a configuration interface. And actually, based on the current status, we hope that we can use open source to combine with our internal resources. So with that, we come up with a plan. So we want to shift from engine's current plan, that is Envoy plus. So at the top layer, this is data. For each service, they have a proxy, and they have the control port here. We use Easter, and we adopt a version of 1.1 to 1.5. And with our test, we found some problem. For example, we do not use main component mix, and so we grade it here. And we mainly use component called the pilot. And for business, previously the business side is on the cloud frame. And in terms of service, we need to connect to KBAS. And for this plan, in terms of data listing, previously, connecting to service, we need to use Nginx, and we need to use 1.8.7.1 to go to crossing, because we want to shift from old plan to the new plan, so we do not want to have much change. At the Envoy side, we want to have the configuration. As we said, we need to use proper configuration. In the URL, we have a service name, and we need to get the service cloud first. If you are familiar with Nginx, as you know, and there is one way in Nginx, for example, ewrite, we can get through rewrite, we can get the service name, service cloud, but actually we do not have this function here, so we need to have the extension on the existing filter. Through the collection managing filter, we made some minor changes, and then we have a rewrite of host and pass. And the data level change is not enough. We also use the control level. We need to cooperate at the control level. This is for the pilot from install. We need to have a configuration of RDS for the current scheme. For the e-commerce website, it's mainly on ATV protocol, because Envoy support listener, so we only use one of the portal. That's enough for us. This is a specific access route, and first we have a URL to visit 127 route, and directly point to 8550 portal, and then visit the URL service path. Then we can get the service cloud, and then through RDS we can transfer to the cluster. And the cluster is a KBAS workload, and it corresponded to a workpoint. Next, I will talk about the internal demand, because for e-commerce, when they do have iterally development, they have a lot of small environments. Because our service has been divided into around 300 microservices, if developers just change a few services, but they need, when they do test, they do not want to deploy all these hundreds of thousands of services in their test environment. So we have multi-environment governance internally. We have this kind of concept. So for
every part, they only test the part they revised, and they just upgrade the existing service, and for the rest they will use the original service. For a lot of developers or QA, every environment is different, so there is the problem of public using of environment. So when we connect to mesh at the proxy level through Envoy or sidecar, how can we solve the problem? How do we do it? First, our scheme is that through control level, we can have directed route through control level. At the development level, we have a source labor to have some certain directions, and through this label we can point to upstream cluster. But for that scheme, actually it's suitable for the previous scenario, but there are some white box here. The white box means for some services, they do not have a correspondent part that have the same color. So if the color do not have a correspondent colored service, then they need to be downgraded, so it's not so feasible. So we come up with another plan. So from the slide you can see here, first of all, for this game, we want to support L4 and L7. That means it can support ATP and TCP protocol. And for the coloring through ingress, we can add some black and cookie to add the color. And for a specific service, at the Envoy side, they have inbound and outbound. Inbound and outbound are different. Inbound is at the left side, at the entry level, through cookie or header, they mark the color, and inbound will get the color and through RDS and find the correspondent cluster. Then Envoy, when transferred to upstream Envoy, they are not using HTTP cookie. We are using HA proxy proxy protocol. We do some extension. From the left side picture, you can see this is the principle. When we have the TCP connection, and we will send PP package, and there is a parameter here, it will state the attribute of the color. So between Envoy through TCP protocol, they can identify the color attribute. In outbound side, when they do the traffic transit, there are some problems that cannot be solved. So later I will explain why it cannot be solved. Here there is an example, and there are two servers. There are two servers, first in person in four service. We will get the person information, and from the slide you can see there are two different colors, and the white means public version, red and green corresponding to the developer's version. The green want to get the information in the green database, and the red want to get the database information marked white.
Solved, and there's no context of bounded outbound. That means the color information from inbound. And then when the service query is assigned, the color would should it be outbound, otherwise outbound cannot get the information about color. And also, it doesn't matter what color of your query, but if it's a service called, if it's white, you need to have a center. And also, if you have your internet, you also need to do some configuration. That's a problem. Thank you, Ms. Lizan, for your introduction and the implementation of the Envoy in Kubernetes. So the polarization of the traffic is a very unique case. Seeing this kind of utilization. And he also talked about the rewrite house. And now it's supported by Envoy. So most of them can be implemented directly with Envoy. Function as a format. So this is the content of our presentations. Thank you for your listening. And if you would like to join any project related to Envoy, welcome to talk to me. And the Tetrate is also recruiting, please pay attention. Thank you, and if you have any questions, please raise your hand. We have about 7 minutes. You said Envoy is a universal data plane. So what's the bottom level layer of solution of Envoy for the top line to achieve high bandwidth and low latency? Codebase is written by C++. And a lot of you have been used for a long time. And also there are some of our own development. We use the library for the NJTTP. And a lot of proxy codes have been tested for a long time. Will the performance be deteriorating with the addition of rules? This may happen, but it's a trade-off between performance and rules. And for functions, you cannot have as many functions as possible without the lowering. And as much as we will try to make sure this kind of performance deterioration is minimized. Does Envoy support double protocols? Reviewing codes right now. There's a team in Alibaba. also working on this design. Do you have made any progress? Please send me an email. I can go to the person in Alibaba, and also I have some issue documents. Thank you. Another question. When you design Envoy, do you have a deep level matching? So, sometimes one photo will drive several functions. So, one photo may have a different business. So, you need to do in depth. But several particles will be one TCP. So you need to do the matching before you know which you want to match with. So you have different particles. In explanation, last lecture. Can compose the as the parts of this particle to know the function of the particle and then extend it to the conversion. Now we have this in the future, but it's a TOS. So on the same photo, you can see the link, whether it's TOS or not. So you can separate them and send them to different filters. So the different protocols in the photo of the canvas distribution. So of course you can do extension through Luma. I don't know how difficult it is to code. We have one Luna filter. We can also do extensions of Luna. Currently, we try to use web sample. In the next 6 months, we may make some progress in